Now I want to bring to the microphone Miss Kristen so that she can introduce this incredible gift that she's about to give us with the children. So Kristen Weaver, one of our applicants.
Good evening, everybody. In the last 15 minutes or so, I just taught the children some of the candy cane dance from Balanchine's Nutcracker.
Everybody's holding your hoop facing forward.
Okay.
watching parents' faces. And that's what makes me cry. I know how they dance.
But y'all go, this is my favorite. That's my favorite. Oh, my goodness.
But I would like to just give the microphone over at this moment to Nora Ellman, who has been here since she was, I believe, 4. And she's now 14.
Yes.
Oh, I keep missing a year. Is that why my hair is white now? All right. Okay. Anyway, we're going to have them just say a little something after each piece, just so you know what SMAPA, which, by the way, Kyle, who is new to us and a wonderful asset. Came into my office a couple of weeks ago and said, "Miss Sharron, what does SMAPA mean?" And I showed him the logo, and I said, "Sharron Miller's Academy for the Performing Arts." And he went, "Diamond, that's what it means, Sharron Miller's Academy for the Performing Arts." So I think I need Nora now to tell you a little bit about what SMAPA means to all of them, and to you. You can go change your clothes for the next piece. So, Nora Ellman.
Hi. Sorry, I'm kind of out of breath. But
why?
So this is, I've been coming here since I was 4, as Sharron said. I'm a sophomore in high school now, and this is my 4th year in the company. And SMAPA is just, like, such a great place. The community is just amazing. Everyone's so welcoming and loving. And especially being in the company and in the scholarship program, it's so great because we have such an amazing opportunity to work with all of these great teachers and have the best dance education that I think you can get anywhere. And, like, we get to work with great choreographers like Christopher Huggins, who worked with Ailey, and Donna, our teacher, and Sharron and Adrian, of course. And it's just amazing, and we all just love each other so much. And I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world. I'm here all the time, and I wouldn't have it any other way. So, thank you all so much for coming, for performing at 7 and 8 also. And don't forget to put in raffle tickets.
Thank you.
Like
it's a
walk away.
No more.
In there is Zumba.
Zumba is in there. Boom. Dance your stuff away. 1 minute to Zumba. Go Zumba yourself.
I will Zumba.
1 minute to Zumba. Stretch your stuff. Do your thing. Sweat some. Hands yours. I just need to see you do your stuff. Zumba starts. Here we go!
Yeah, nigga, you always do the dance. You tell your friends out of their mind. It's about time to get.
Me and my proprietor is next, so big, big girls on dick. Now that I'm on a real for mix. I want my phone and I cash my check. That's how the money girl gets on your way. Wow. She got a dog. 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 She got a dog.
Thank you.
You're now going to see the performance workshop ensemble again. And this is a special piece called Grace. This year we have been fortunate enough to expand our faculty, expand our enrollment, expand our scholarships, not that I'm begging, but we expanded our faculty and we added a wonderful teacher whose name is Donna Murray. And Donna is hiding somewhere. Yeah. And Donna created this most beautiful piece, and I'm going to have her talk to you and introduce it. And so I proudly present Donna Moe.
Thank you. I didn't know I'd be speaking about the piece, but I'm happy to do that. The title is Grace, and the music is Hallelujah by Jeff Buckley. And what can I say about it? We wanted to make something beautiful together. That was our main purpose, and explore a movement that was perhaps outside of what the students normally do on a daily basis here. And so you'll see quite a bit of contact work. You'll see maybe a different quality to their movement. And beyond that, the interpretation or images or what it means to you is up to you. But I hope you enjoy the piece. Thank you.
Thank you. Baby, I've been here before. I've seen this room and I've walked this floor. Yeah, I used to live alone before. Yeah. But I've seen your flag on the marble arch. And love is not a victory march. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah.
Thank you, ladies. means a lot to me. And that kind of sums up why I dance and many of us inspire to dance. It's from Merce Cunningham, a world-renowned artist. It says, you have to love dancing to stick to it. It gives you nothing back, no manuscripts to store away, no paintings to show on walls and maybe hang in museums, no poems to be printed and sold, nothing but that single fleeting moment when you feel alive. This means a lot to me of why I dance and everything. I came here 3 years ago. I took summer classes with Sharron Miller and ballet and West African and the whole deal. And one summer, I was surprised to receive a letter. And it was an invitation to join a company. And it meant a lot because I knew someone saw potential in me as an individual and a dancer. Soon that fall, I joined the company, I enrolled in class, and I became part of the family. A lot of people ask us, why do you come so much to dance 5-6 times a week? In my case, I come an hour away just to come here. And what it is we're well-trained. It's something we're passionate about. And we have made friends and we have a family here. And every Saturday when we come, we work with talented other dancers, teachers, choreographers that support us and are always there, you know, if we need help or anything. And you guys being here have become part of our family, and that's why we like your support. You being here and also financial support, that's why we're able to be here. And you never know whose life you're touching by your donation and whose dream can come true through it. Thank you very much.
Thank you. run into. This is your home. You know that, right?
Aren't they fabulous?
Turn around and bow to them. Our own theater, you never know. And then you all won't be in the back. You'll be like in the 15th row back that way. But I have to thank each and every one of them, and I want to be able to introduce them before Hannah has to talk. So down at the end, we are losing Maura Shannon because she is a seat. Maura Shannon. Maura Toomey. Well, Shannon is her twin. So it became Maura Shannon. Maura Toomey, because she is a senior this year. And Maura, take a bow. Fortunately, Rory is only 14. Rory Furey-King, take a bow. Fortunately, Nora Ellman is only 15. Take a bow. Kyle Martin, who is totally new to us and such an asset, thank you so much. He's 14. Take a bow. Vivian Belosky, who is only 14. Terina Turner, who is also new to us and is 15, or is it 16? Ah, gosh, 16. Hannah Garner, who is a senior, 17, has been with us since she was a mere child. Take a bow. Savanna Lowe, 13. Take it back. I believe Lauren Bomberg is 16. Take it back. And again, Maura Shannon. Shannon Toomey, who is also a senior. Take it back. Marisa Illingworth, who is 16. Take a bow. And Kayla Perez-Vega, who is a senior. We're losing her too. Take a bow. However, in the audience, I'm sure that there are the people that are coming to take their place next year. I don't know who they are, but I see a little Olivia Lowe over there. And I'm sure that she will be here next year going to her sister, Savannah.
What am I supposed to do now?
But anyway, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Hannah is going to tell you, before you go and let me pick the raffle and all that stuff and pay some more money and all that, she's going to tell you what this has meant to her. And I'm going to say to the rest of you, thank you, thank you, with all my heart, thank you.
You can get dressed now.
Hi, everyone. I'm Hannah, and I'm 17 years old, and I'm a senior, as Sharron said. This is my fourth year in the company, so I've been doing this for a while. And as a senior, my year has been really stressful, taking a lot of rigorous classes and applying to college, but throughout all of that, SMAPA has been my steady home, second home, almost my first home, because I spent so much time here anyway. A lot of us take, you know, up to 13 classes a week, I guess. And it's all thanks to you guys, and thanks to Sharron, and Adrian, and Kristen, and everyone here. And it just means so much to me. And, well, I don't even know what to say. I've been here since I guess I was probably 4 years old. And
wow.
It just it means so much to me.
See, that's why I do this. Because they care. These are kids that care about what they're doing. They are not picking up guns. They are not picking up people off the street. They're not smoking. They're not doing drugs. They're caring about giving back. And that's what all these young people do. Why this government takes away from them, I don't know. But some of us have to give back to them. I care. She cares. And she's going to go on, and she's going to make something really happen in this world. All these kids are going to make something really happen because they know from the foundation of their spirit what they're about. So you can say, thank you.
You're going to replace Lauren when she's a senior and she has to go?
You're going to be a performance yourself?
It works for you.
Okay, so she has a couple more years
left.
And then we'll have Allison. We got it covered.
What is there to say? This was a really worthwhile event. And I think when you come to think about children and think about the arts and the need that we have for people to support it, events like this bring out children, bring out families, and let them know what can be done with a young person who's gifted and talented if you give them half a shot. And tonight I think we did. So thank you.